If you're old enough, you'll know that Singapore's postal code used to be just 2 digits, then 4 digits, and eventually it's 6 digits now. What you might not know is that some people are still using the 2-digit postal code. Watch on and you will know why. So, before you understand postal code, you need to understand the history behind it. You see, long ago, back in 1950, to facilitate the postal service to send mails, Singapore was divided into 28 districts. District 1 is Raffles Place, Cecil, Marina and People's Park area. District 2 is Anson and Tanjong Pagar. It then goes all the way to District 28. This is done so that the postal service will know where to sort the mails. If it's in Orchard Road, then it's in District 9 and they can give it to the postman that deliver mails in District 9. Now, most of us no longer use the district number except for property agents, who will say,
"This property is in the prestigious District 10.
Which you all don't even know where the head District 10 is. Book it team out, just say so, say District 10 for what side? Yeah, you get the idea. Property agents are the main people who use the district codes now. Because since 1979, we no longer use the district codes. You see, from 1979, as there are more people in Singapore, we need more districts. Cause just imagine this. In the past, one postman might be able to deliver mails to everyone in District 9. But when more people live in District 9, we need 2 postmen, and they need to know where to deliver in District 9. That was when each district has a sector code as well. Yes, each district was further divided into smaller areas. For example, remember that I said District 1 has Raffles Place, Cecil, Marina and People's Park area? Well, that was where each area would have a postal sector as well. So since District 1 is O1, then let's say Raffles Place has a postal sector of O4, then its postal code will therefore be O104. It's the district followed by the postal sector in that district. Another example is say District 22, which is Jurong. If Jurong West postal sector is 64, then the postal code is 2264. Get the idea so far? It's like dividing each district into sub-district, so each team of postmen can just head to one sub-district to deliver the mails. But well, as you know, Singapore's population kept on increasing, and by 1995, we cannot divide by sub-district anymore. If you are looking to advertise your business in this channel, we can help you. There are guaranteed views and many big brands have trusted us. Just click on the link in the description. Now you know the origins of the postal code, you should know what's next. In 1995, as Singapore became denser, we need to further divide the area, and this time, we zoom in all the way to each individual building. Technically, it's to each delivery point, because each building is a delivery point. It's now a 6-digit code, with the first 2 digits being the postal sector number, and the last 4 digits as the delivery point. Yeah, this means the district number no longer matters. For example, for our office building in Bukit Batok, the district is 23, but that doesn't matter. Our postal sector is 65. Our office building is 10 Bukit Batok Crescent, and since our postal code is 658079, our delivery point is 8079. The delivery point is a random 2. Like for example, for HDB, the last 3 digits is the block number. For others, the delivery point is assigned based on the alphabetical sequence of the street names in each sector. According to SimPost back then, this will allow them to sort mail faster. So yes, if you realize, the postal code has one key objective. Just like what the name suggests, postal code is indeed used mainly for postal services. Since in the past, letters are very important. Nowadays, with each building having its own postal code in Singapore, we have all also used it to locate buildings like keying in the postal code in our GPS. And this is why it will not work overseas, because in some other countries, it might not be the same system. Usually, each of their postal code or zip code is one area and not one building. So don't go overseas to key in the postal code only to realize that it doesn't bring you to the place you want to go lah. In the meantime, do you know that you can actually start working legally from 13 years old? Watch this to know the legal age for almost everything in Singapore, from 7 years old to 65 years old. Also, follow me on Instagram if you have not done so, as we publish exclusive short videos there. Link in description. And if you want to advertise with us, even as a standalone video, do contact us. Thank you for spending almost 4 minutes with me. I really appreciate it and hope you learn something.